This is the FLYCAM Junior Stabilizer. I've had this for about a year, and I use it sometimes on occasion. For those of you who don't know, I'm not just a comic book artist, but a film and a photographer enthusiast as well. And I'm always trying to find something that'll make it just a little bit more cinematic and special. And they have the expensive $400, $500 GlideCams you can get, the HD 3000s, and there's nothing wrong with that, but I'd rather invest in something a little bit smaller and cheaper for the meantime, since I'm just starting out with this hobby of mine. But anyway, this is the FLYCAM Junior. Was it 70 bucks off Amazon? And I've never really adjusted everything on it, but I'm trying today to see what I can actually get done with it. But I want to actually try to get some better cinematic results. So the standardized drop test is, if you hold it parallel to the ground, if you let it go, you should, if you got a good stabilization, you should get a good, it was it 1 to 2 second drop time. So if we let it go, 1001, 1002, that's good. So I think it looks good that way. And if you hold it vertical, if it's too top heavy, it'll lean forward. So you need to adjust these little pins here to go, you slide this plate back and forth. If it's too heavy backwards, you slide them and you adjust it, go forward that way. So if you hold it vertical like that and to the ground, and it looks, I think it looks pretty good. It's pretty sharp actually. So I've got my Canon Rebel T3i EOS camera on it. It's a pretty decent, it's very good. Canon's a good brand, first of all. So it's kind of a heavy camera. But I think I've adjusted the pins. Again, the orange pins go, they slide the plate forward or backwards or left to right. And that's how you adjust the glide plate on there. All right, but I think we should get some pretty good footage. So let's go out and see what we can get done.
Yeah.